What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
And welcome back to Good Bad and Filmy. What are we doing today?
We're doing It Chapter 2, baby.
Yeah, this is a follow-up to It Chapter 1. Obviously, this is an adaptation of Stephen King's novel.
Yep, continuation.
And this, exactly. Chapter 2 picks up 27 years after Chapter 1.
Which is when he resurfaces.
Exactly. And the kids have now grown up. The losers have now grown up.
They've grown up and they've all moved out.
Absolutely.
And they need to come back.
So first and foremost, man, for me, I loved It Chapter 1 so much. That It Chapter 2 was one of my most anticipated movie of the year. One of them, like we had Avengers Endgame in this year, but this again was one of my most anticipated movies of the year.
Right, I was very late on the It bandwagon, thanks to this guy. Obviously, I saw It 1 at home, and I always assumed that it was a kids movie and it's about kids, but I love those damn kids.
Yeah, dude, they have such a good chemistry. They understand, like, you look at them and you can understand these guys are really friends. Like, this is exactly how friends are around each other.
Exactly.
So that chemistry, I think everybody in the world, like whoever seen the movie, bought it. Everyone loved the kids. Everyone loved the old losers.
Yep.
And now they're back. They're back and bigger.
They're back and bigger. And you had a good time.
Like, I had a good time. I really enjoyed the cast. Even when the rumors are out, when the casting was going on, Andy Muschietti, I think he did a really good job of, you know, getting people as a replacement for these kids,
right,
as their elder counterparts. I think he's done a fantastic job there. But yeah, that we can dive into once we're in the goods.
Goods, baby, coming right at ya.
So yeah, continue on from what I just started off. The cast is amazing. All these people, we've got James McAvoy, we've got Bill Hader, we've got Jessica Chastain, and we've got other people. We've got Andy Bean coming in. We've got a lot of new guys coming in as the elder counterparts of the losers.
Right.
And I think of all the movies that I've ever seen, Hollywood, Bollywood, big screen, small screen, period, everything, this is probably the best, like, elder casting that I've ever seen for something.
Right.
Like, it's so believable to me, at least.
Okay. I mean, on paper, yes, this cast was insane. You do not get a bigger cast than getting James McAvoy, Jessica Chastain, etc., etc. Bill Hader, man, like, he was just like a laugh riot.
Yeah,
like, he was,
absolutely,
like, really cool.
But he was full Finn Wolfhard grown up. See, like, literally.
But somehow, I don't know, for me, it was almost like, obviously, like, I have this bias where I prefer still sort of believing and knowing it from the kids' perspectives.
Yeah.
Where the scares and the whole concept of Pennywise, you know, it's just more bigger, better, stronger.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And they're just sort of rounding it off and finishing it off, which is why, you know, they're adults and they come back and everything else to do with that. But I don't know, somehow only Bill Hader was, like, enjoyable for me. And obviously, like, Bill Skarsgård is untouchable.
Of course, Bill Skarsgård, as Pennywise, I think he is untouchable.
Right.
He's created a name for himself now.
Yes.
Just playing this one role, he was so good in it. And you know, the creepy eyes that only he can do.
Yeah,
I do not want to meet this guy in a dark alley.
Yeah, that was so cool. So Bill Hader comes to Skarsgård in full Pennywise costume. And he's like, how do you do that separate eye moving in the first movie? That must be in special effects, right? And Skarsgård is like, do you mean this? And he actually doesn't. Bill Hader's like, what the hell?
Dead.
So that was really cool.
Yeah, absolutely. Bill Skarsgård was amazing as Pennywise.
Right.
And not just that. For me, I think I really enjoy the whole concept of how these guys have moved on in their lives. They're away. They've been away from Derry. That story aspect, I enjoy how they come back.
Hmm.
And they've almost, the entire, they've kind of forgotten about the entire incident. Everything is very hazy.
Because it's traumatizing.
Exactly. Not just that. The fact that they've moved away from Derry and how they
so
fit
far
into
away,
it. Exactly.
Yeah.
So everything, the entire thing is really hazy to them.
Yes.
They've had some sort of memory loss almost,
right,
I'd say.
But when they come back, it all starts going back.
Yeah, everything starts coming back. So I really enjoyed those parts.
Right. And even like some scenes, they were shot really, really well.
Absolutely.
I mean, this is I don't know if this counts as a horror movie, as a thriller movie, maybe a combination of both.
Right.
But you have to be so smart in coming up with ways to show, you know, the world of Pennywise and why he does what he does and how he does what he does.
Right.
That obviously I was really blown away the first movie, so I had some expectations for the second movie. And when it came to Pennywise, 100%, a lot of very visual stuff going
Not
on.
Not just that, like, big props to Andy Muschietti, man.
Yes.
The way he's directed some shots, the way he's framed shots,
yes,
they're done really, really, really well.
Right.
So I think,
enough about it.
All in all, I had some fun. There's obviously fun to be had here. This is a good follow-up, but yeah, let's get into the bads now.
Yes.
Man.
This movie has a runtime of almost 3 hours. That's 2 hours, 49 minutes to be specific.
The bad thing is that it feels long.
It is long.
It is long and it feels long. There are some good movies who know how to carry it, who know how to do the pacing well.
Right.
Even though they're 3 hours long, you enjoy it so much, you're so, you know, in it,
right,
that it doesn't feel 3 hours long.
Right.
This movie, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, and I get that. So basically, they're sort of justifying when these people come back, and literally,
right,
like, each character almost has their own individual moment or scene or set.
Absolutely.
Where, you know, they're sort of igniting that Derry connection.
Right.
So I get that you want to do it for each and every character, but in terms of pacing, I was already done, like, long before the third act and the final act came to play. I was like,
oh, right.
So it's just, I don't know. And yeah, obviously, you know, the kids come in and there everywhere. There's some flashbacks.
Right.
Right. So I don't know, man, just simply that, along with, and because they were showing the kids every now and then, I just wanted to see more and more of the kids. So I was almost like done with the adults by then. So yeah, towards the end, while the set pieces were really cool, I didn't buy into them as much as I thought I would.
I get really where you're coming from. I think that's particularly because everybody loved the kids so much that,
right,
that complete perspective change of now seeing Pennywise from an adult's perspective,
yes,
it really hampers how you view the movie,
right,
and especially when it's 3 hours long, it, you know, kind of starts dragging in the middle a little,
right.
I understand that. For me, I think the third act was especially long. Like, I didn't expect it to be that long, the final complete sequence.
Right.
And that's where I thought it started dragging a little bit more.
Right.
But all in all, I did have some fun with it. But again, it does not, you know, stand up to the first movie. The first movie is definitely better, but this, I think, is a decent follow.
Maybe, but as long as I kept on seeing Mini Jack Dylan Grey.
Oh yeah,
the guys,
even Finn Wolfhard as a potty mouth in the group, man, what a guy.
Yeah, I mean, he's so cute, and like, I actually saw him first in Shazam, because I saw it after that. And obviously Shazam was such a likable character, but he just like steals the show for me. And while each and every kid has their own role to play,
right,
Jack Dylan Grey, you have my heart. So yeah, why don't we get into some Filmy?
Absolutely.
Yo. Talking about certain scenes that I personally really like, this was also in the trailer as well.
Right.
You actually get to see Pennywise in human form, so
right,
to say, which is basically Bill Skarsgård applying white paint on his face, and oh my god, that scene was...
And this entire scene comes into play when Jessica Chastain visits the creepy old lady back in her previous house. She goes back to collect a souvenir. And that old lady and that entire set piece, oh my god, it just did it for me. Like, I saw it in the trailers, and I just knew this movie was going to be amazing.
Yeah.
And even though I wouldn't call it amazing, I had a lot of fun with it, especially because of scenes like this.
Yes.
And talking about Jessica Chastain, there's a lot of blood involving her, man, in some scenes.
Yeah, it's like, obviously, like, throughout the whole movie, even though these characters have moved on, Jessica Chastain's character has a lot to do with blood in the first movie.
Right.
The no escaping blood second time around. So, I mean, I saw some.
It's worse.
Yeah, I saw some IMDb articles where it too has set some weird ass record of using the most amount of blood for one scene.
That's probably the creepiest record you can ever set.
Right. And that is horrible. I think more than everyone else, I think Jessica Chastain's character, I think, deals with the most, both it-wise and non-it-wise as well.
Right.
And we get to see a lot of that as well, but definitely some really freaky, creepy stuff going on.
Absolutely. Even when the characters are back, even as grown-ups, I think that chemistry between them where Richie is still picking on Eddie, that chemistry is still there, and that's probably the only thing that I could latch on to, and which is I had the amount of fun that I did. So for me, I was maybe a worthy successor, not exactly a worthy successor, but a good follow-up, I'd say. So I'm viewing it as it, right? So it's chapter 1 and 2.
Right.
I probably want to see it as like it in one go.
One go.
Which will be like a 5-hour epic, and that's going to be fun. So
that's
exactly why I say it's a worthy follow-up.
Basically Avengers, Infinity Saga.
Absolutely. This is exactly what this is.
Right. But no, I think for me personally, I think I'd go back only to the first movie and not watch the second one again, because I just don't have the stamina to watch so much of them, and and the kids, man, Jack Dylan Grey, Finn Wolfhard, those guys are next level, man. So
absolutely.
Yeah, but minus Bill Hader being like totally surprising me, the rest I think I could still miss them and still enjoy it.
Let's get into the ratings then, man.
Considering everything that's gone on for this 11, 12, 15 minute video, I hope not. But for me, it's a one and done, man. I enjoyed the set pieces, I enjoyed the cinematography, but it only reminds me of the first movie and I'd rather go back to that. So for me, it's a clear one and done.
I can't deal with this negativity. Leave this room right now. Alright, so I had fun with this movie. There is fun to be had. If you're a fan of it, if you're a fan of Pennywise, if you're a fan of The Losers, there is some things that you will like. There are some things that where you will feel the movie probably does drag on. Yes. But all in all, I think this is an enjoyable follow-up to the first movie. So I definitely give it a thumbs up, man.
Easy to please.
Yeah. No standard. So that wraps up our review of It Chapter 2. Let us know in the comments below, what was the scariest set piece in the movie that you guys saw?
Yep. And favorite character as well, I'm Jack Dylan Grey all the way.
Yeah, I'm Bill Hader, dude, for this movie at least.
For this movie, yeah. I'd say so. So yeah, that's all. Thank you so much.
It's been great having you guys here. Be back for more, a lot more content coming your way really, really soon. Thank you so much for all your love and support. And yeah, like, share, subscribe as usual and be back for more, guys.
#GBF.
See you soon.